Good day, y'all. I'm getting ready to bring y'all an interesting dinner today, a great meal. I've got some baby red skin potatoes. I'm going to cook some Cornish hens and some steamed broccoli. I'm going to start with my potatoes. These are going to be roasted potatoes with fresh dill, garlic, and chopped shallots, or sliced shallots, should I say. I'm going to start first by cutting all of my potatoes in half. Or halving my potatoes. And I have them in water. Because when you cut a potato and air starts to hit it, it'll begin to turn brown. So as long as they're in that water, they won't brown. And also, this is a good rinse, just a bath for them. My other ingredients for this meal are going to be black pepper, table salt, garlic powder, extra virgin olive oil, of course, and a little bit of wine. The reason why I'm using wine is because it's going to be in a butter wine sauce. And that is for these roasted red skin potatoes. Baby red. But I guess I can't tell y'all to respect the process without showing you the process. And then after I get done doing this, I'm going to begin to prepare my Cornish hens. I like using fresh dill. It's a pretty good herb. It's good with potatoes, very good with potatoes. So I'm gonna go ahead and rinse this water up off of these. So now I'm gonna apply my potatoes to the pan that I'm gonna be roasting them in. Try to keep the flesh side up. Very important that you do that. This is what is gonna consume most of the flavor, is the flesh. So that's a layer. And I add in just a little sprinkle of salt. Just a little sprinkle of salt. Okay. A little sprinkle of garlic powder. A little sprinkle of black pepper. And then I add some of my herbs. So I'm going to use this garlic. Put the garlic in. Everything is layered in this dish so that everything is evenly distributed. Put some shallots in there. Spread them around. And put some dill in there. I've chopped the dill up. Alright, get in there. Take a good look at that. That's just layer one. So I go back and repeat that. Same thing again. Put another layer on top of that layer. And as you can see, these layers are going to coat the first. And then you just repeat that cycle again. A little salt, garlic powder, black pepper. After you do that, garlic. We're going to go ahead and finish up the garlic because we are officially done with that layer. We're done layering, period. Shallots. Do it again. Done layering. So we're going to use it all. And then the rest of this dill goes right in on the top. Chop it on off with the dill. Now what I'm gonna do is 3/4 of a stick of butter, just 6 tablespoons. Take that 6 tablespoons of butter and put it in this little cup here, bowl, cup, whatever, however you wanna look at it. Put a few splashes of Sauvignon Blanc in there, maybe about 3 ounces should do. Like I said, I'm good with the eyeball. Maybe 2 tablespoons of olive oil. And this is going to go into the microwave just to melt the butter down. Okay, so we just melted down 6 tablespoons of butter, 3 ounces of Sauvignon Blanc wine, and 2 tablespoons of extra virgin olive oil, give or take. And this is our dish, and we're going to just pour this, we stuck this butter in the microwave to melt it down. And we're just going to pour it all over everything. Just coat everything. pour that all in there. What happens next is cover it with some aluminum foil and stick it in the oven on 400 degrees. And stick that in there just to get the potatoes done. Once the potatoes are, well, not done, but cooking, you know, getting them softer. Once they're soft, I'm going to take the foil off and put them back in the oven and let them finish off. Okay, now for my next dish, we got these Cornish hens here. I got them backside up, so I go ahead and season the back. I'm gonna cook them this side up, but I'm gonna season the backside. So let's spread the wings a little bit, just to make sure everything gets everywhere. First, I'm gonna hit it with some Lawry seasoning salt. Just basic, boom, bam, bam. A little bit of onion powder, okay? Onion powder. Again, another harmless seasoning. It's not gonna hurt nothing. Black pepper. Remember, I told you every base starts with salt and pepper. And my old faithful, that Lawry's garlic salt, baby. Take that down through there. Real good, real good. Okay, all right, all right. And I got some Italian herb seasoning, Kroger brand. And this is the savory and spicy. And this is a grinder. So I'm gonna just grind some of that up on the back of this bird here. All three. Yeah, pretty good, pretty good. Okay, and massage them, you know, let the moisture in the skin absorb those seasonings so it don't fall off. Just press it on in. Okay. Flip my birds over. Repeat step one. Season salt, that Lawry's. I'm just going light with that. Onion powder. Just make sure you get some everywhere. That's all. That's why I go back and forth. Black pepper. That Lawry's garlic salt. And that savory and spicy. So this is just a blend of like rosemary, red pepper, I believe it's some garlic in here, thyme, sea salt. Same thing to this side. Add a little pressure, a little pressure, a little pressure. This is my pan that I'm going to start these birds off in. And it's just got a little bit of olive oil coating in there, just so this stuff doesn't stick, okay? Olive oil, rub it around in there real good, make sure it gets distributed pretty well. And this is my biggest one, so I'm gonna put him in the center. And we're gonna lay all the birds in opposite directions. All right, it's gonna tuck up like this fella, right here like that. And we got, you know what? Let me see something real quick. I'm experimenting. Because these two are a little smaller. Okay, we'll do that like this. Gotta keep your hands washed. Got my aluminum foil. I'm gonna cover that. Stick it in the oven on 400 degrees. And just let it begin to barely cook. You thought I was done? That gets way more complex. Thank you. I got a stick of butter. Okay. And I'm gonna put some olive oil in here. That's about 3 tablespoons. Maybe even 4. Whatever it is, it's fine. You know why? Because this is just simply a baste. Knife. Cut this butter up. I'm gonna use that whole stick though. Put it in that. Same little thing I melted the butter down for the potatoes. Nothing major. And then I got another 2 tablespoons left over from that first stick of butter I used for the potatoes. Now this is rosemary. I've chopped the rosemary up. I'm gonna put that in there, okay? And this is garlic. I'm gonna put that in there. All of this is going in here for my base. And you looking at that orange like, what is that, dessert? Nah, baby. It's part of the base too. Yeah. This shit is non-compliant, ain't it? Get all that in there. Now that's all in there. Put a little bit of that garlic salt in there. That loves. All right, it's in there. Drizzle that top. I'll put this in the microwave. So now I just pulled that out of the microwave just to melt that base down. This is what I'm gonna baste the chicken with, okay? Once it's been in there for about maybe 30, 45 minutes. Just wanna let them start to cook in the middle. Cause when I take them out, I'm gonna remove the foil layer. And then I'm gonna just let it roast with this base on there. And that's what's gonna make it have that pretty brown color. Got this orange out sitting here that you was wondering about. We're putting some orange zest in here. Orange zest going in there. Mm-hmm. That's right. A nice amount in there. Again, ain't gonna hurt nothing. Just gonna add a nice citrusy flavor to what's already going on. And you just wanna take that spoon, wave that all around in there, and now it's present. Okay? That orange zest is present in everything. So now I take this orange and I'm gonna cut it. You cutting? Yep. Because we're going to put some of that juice in there, too. Don't be shy with it. So now I'll just sit with my baste. Let it sit here. Give it a good stir. Keep it stirred up. Because, you know, these things start to separate as it cools. These birds out of the oven. And took the foil off. And now begins the basting process. That baste that I whipped up in front of y'all. Let me set this back here because I can't really see it. So I'm just basting these down. Get ready to put them back in the oven. Get ready to put back in. See, I had to let that base cool. See, it was real liquidy when I had first melted it. Now it's cool. It got some consistency to it again. And that's a good thing. This is going to be so good. I know it looks good already,